वालेकुम अस्सलाम वरहमतुल्लाह वबरकातुहु। कैसे का शेख?
जज़ाकअल्लाह खैरन।
शेख, आई हैव बीन लिसनिंग टू योर लेक्चर्स ऑन हुदा टीवी अबाउट द बिल्डिंग ऑफ अ बेटर फ्यूचर एंड अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ अल्लाह आई एम वेरी हैप्पी फॉर दोस सीरीज एंड मे अल्लाह ब्लेस यू एंड ऑल दोस पीपल इन्वॉल्वड इन दैट सीरीज।
जज़ाकअल्लाह खैरन।
क्वेश्चन टू यू इज, आई लिसन टू ईच एंड एवरी एपिसोड ऑफ योर्स and I made a note of all the points that you pointed out, and alhamdulillah the tarbiya that you said to give in school at home, if that's been done, alhamdulillah the masjid has been done, and I'm talking about girls, my two daughters,
alhamdulillah.
But the problem is now my daughter is going to an Islamic school. The standard that you set for the Islamic school, that is 100% not there, but at least 70% it is there.
No.
The problem is now my daughter, who's the eldest one, and she's in grade 7, and you know, parents of public schools are sending their children to Islamic school as girls start growing up. Now new girls come in and they are watching movies at home, reading Harry Potter books,
no,
and all those things which are junk according to me.
No.
My daughter comes back home and tells me, why can't I read it? I try to convince her that it is a wastage of time, it is a wastage. How do I handle that problem?
First of all, I want to say may Allah reward you for making dua for me. And I really appreciate the fact that you watch Building a Better Future. And maybe a lot of the viewers are not aware of this series that actually has been presented on Gaira's TV as well so far, I think. The brothers on Gaira's TV showed it, and it's available on YouTube, Building a Better Future. It's really about the future of the Ummah, that if we want to change the condition of the Muslims, we must focus on our children, and we must direct our attention to them, and we must do our best to nourish them and bring them up as devoted Muslims who live in America, okay, who can deal with the society in America and help America. We're part of the fabric of America, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. And America is really desperate for the morals that Islam has to present, the manners, the character that Islam can produce. And we can prepare our children to be that role model for American kids. Of course, in the series, I talked about the attributes and the qualities of that generation that we need to bring forth to head Islam and Muslims. And then I got into the issue of the institutions which will basically work on producing that generation. And I mentioned the home, the Muslim home. The home must be a Muslim home, husband, wife committed to the mission. They already married one another on the basis of religion. They know that their job is to nourish their children and make sure that they are basically brought up as Muslims, and they are going to do whatever it takes to make this happen. The second institution is the masjid, that we make sure that the masjid is simply teaching the sunnah. The imam is not following a hearsay, or he's not basically following just one school of thought. I think in America, I'm talking in America, that we must bring our children to merge into the Ummah at large. This is two. And here is the third component, or the third institution, which our sister's question belonged to, which is the school. Unfortunately, and I really want to say this to you, my dear sister, you're going to find these problems in every single Muslim school, Islamic school in America. Because after all, we have not matured yet as a community in running our Islamic schools the way that they should be running. And sometimes you find the administration running the school properly, but yet you find these elements which spoil your work, which is in the case of your daughters, the peer pressure. That alhamdulillah, here you are, you're a committed parent, and you did your best at home, and you made sure that the masjid is also doing their job, and you did your best, and here you are, you're sacrificing money money and energy and time, and placing your children in Islamic schools and paying that high tuition, which is, I'm telling my brothers and sisters in Islam, have the right intention that this is for the sake of Allah, that spending is in the sake of Allah, and Allah will bless your wealth and your property and your money, and whatever you're spending, Allah will give it back to you. But yet, subhanallah, you find these these bad tomatoes in the basket with your children, where they basically distract your work and maybe cause it or damage it. And by default, children look at one another. What I would advise my sister in this case is to make sure that you report this to the principal, to the administration. Let them talk about it. Meaning, let the principal or the teachers talk about the ruling regarding Harry Harry Butler, whatever his name is, this crazy guy, and this magic guy, which magic is haram anyways for us to follow, sorcery and all that witchcraft business, these movies. Have the teacher, which is the authority in the school, address the issues in the institution. And let those who are not watching this know that they are doing the right thing, and those who are watching or reading this stuff is doing the wrong thing. Add to this, I would encourage you at home to let your daughters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and keep them steadfast, ya Rab, on the religion of Islam, that if you obey the majority of people on earth, they will take you astray. And we as Muslims, we do not follow people. Ya ikhwa, Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu, Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu, has a statement that is to be written with ink made out of gold. You know what he said? اعرف الحق تعرف أهله. Know the truth, you will know who is on the truth. فَإِنَّ الْحَقَّ لَا يُعْرَفُ بِالرِّجَالِ. But don't learn the truth through people. Don't say, you know what, I'm following this person because of him. La. Learn what is the right thing to do, and then you will find out who is doing the right thing. In this case, this is what we need to instill into the hearts and minds of our daughters and our sons, because at the end of the day, sooner or later, they are going to get across or become across or meet somebody who is not really committed to the religion because their parents did not do what you did. They did not do their job. The masjid did not do what they are supposed to do, like the masjid where you live. And don't forget the dua, inshallah. And my sister, be patient. Wallahi, be patient. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, inshallah, grant your mission success. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Jazakallahu khairan.
جزاك الله خير. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.